Curiosity is an interest in the world and how and why things work in it. Children have a natural propensity to be curious, and it's our job not just to encourage it because it is so natural, our job is often to make sure it happens within boundaries and doing all this without shutting it down or dampening it. In order to do this, it's important that we apply one of the most fundamental principles that Dr. Greenspan came up with. This is following the lead. Now, unfortunately, many people misinterpret what following the lead means. Some people think it means letting children do whatever they want and joining them in that. And unfortunately, with many videos you see of people doing floor time or talking about floor time, you literally see them following a child around a room, picking up objects and putting them down, and literally doing that over and over to the point of not benefiting the child. However, Dr. Greenspan believed that following the lead meant being in tune with what your child was interested in, taking their cues and then expanding on it, not doing it verbatim. Let's say our child is interested in how something works. They want to take it apart. Do we encourage them to do it within proper guidelines by using a screwdriver, helping them take the pieces off so they don't break? Or do we just let them rip it apart and see what's inside? Again, this choice can be up to us, but if we're part of it with them, if we're encouraging them while participating ourselves, we're following their lead, but we're also helping them expand by figuring out how to do it in possibly a more safe and controlled manner. The goal is not to teach or direct, all while at the same time showing an interest in your child's interests so they know we're in their corner. They know we are actually interested in them and what they are doing, which will allow them to feel safe and secure with future exploration. Now, as we progress, this curiosity actually leads to and brightens up our creativity. And then we become more logical and we start really thinking about how the world works and what these connections mean. Why does this happen? Why didn't that happen? If we don't wonder why, then we don't ask sometimes the important questions. And when we're not asking the important questions, we're also not exploring to come up with new ideas or figure out new discoveries. We may not even inquire about why bad things are happening. This continues to progress, this curiosity about how the world works around us, especially the things we're deeply interested in, i.e. our emotional connections to the world around us. This begins again to expand, and it doesn't only allow us to be curious about these external aspects of the world, but now because the external world is connected to our emotions, our desires, our interests, we now become reflective and introspective, and we now have the ability to think about our internal world. Why do I feel this way? What are my dreams? What are my pursuits? Where do I want to be in 5 years? If we're not curious about how the world works around us, we often don't transition into being curious about how our inner world is working. So you can see something like curiosity leads to these higher level reflective capacities, and they feed off of one another. Reflection also encourages more curiosity, because if we figure something out about ourselves, we tend to then want to take another look at something else, or we uncover something else that we were unaware of, and now we want to explore that as well. One of the most important ways to encourage this curiosity, as well as creativity, is to nurture a child's opinions, not facts. Remember, the antithesis of what we're talking about is factual, memorized, repetitive, rote learning. And unfortunately, asking children specific questions, what is this? What color is it? What's its name? These questions are not going to encourage these higher level, great kid or emotional capacities. However, asking an opinion, not what is that, but what do you like about it? So not what did you do at school today, which is a factual representation of a sequence of events, but instead what was fun at school, or what did you like about your day, or what didn't you like about your day? Was there anything bad that happened? Or what's your favorite thing to do with your best friend? These types of questions, which are complicated for some kids, are opinion-based questions. But it helps them think outside the box, helps them be more curious, and also ask questions themselves. We've found clinically that when we ask children questions in an open-ended and opinion-based format, that they are more inclined to start asking the exact same questions themselves. We often see as children start answering more who, what, when, where, and especially why questions throughout their developmental process, that when they are able to tell us why they want to do something or why they did something, then soon after they start asking their caregivers, parents, and other people in their lives, why did you do that? Or why can't I do something? These are showing that the child is curious. They're wanting to learn. They want information. And this also needs to be nurtured.